Welcome back, guys. We're going to check on the rabbit poop in the red wiggler bin. Welcome. For those of you that are new here, I am the garden and worm lady. I've been a worm farmer for 20 years. In January, it'll be 21 years. I look at all my comments and I try to answer every question. So if you're new here, go ahead, like and subscribe. Press that little bell so you don't miss my videos. So let's look over here. What is the temperature still going at? It's actually a little lower than it was yesterday. So that goes to show you that rabbit manure is not a hot compost. It's not going to heat up like like cow or horse will. Now, I have not seen this today, so we're going to do it together. Let's see what they're doing. Oh, boy. Oh, my gosh. Well, it looks like the majority that were over here moved over to the chow side, and now the chow is gone. Interesting. I never touch that manure unless I have gloves on because, well, it is rabbit poop. Interesting though, huh? It's been a cool experiment. I'll give them a few more days. And then we're going to mix in the poop and just see what happens. I found some rotberries in my fridge. And I've let them sit here a little bit so they could get a little more moldy. And the nursery bins, which these three are giant nursery tubs. These all have red wigglers in them. And these also don't have blues. But they're doing well. They're doing great. They're growing up. Look at them right under the surface. They're doing wonderful. Look, they're a nice worm. Look at that. It's a nice size for a red wiggler right there. And just because red wigglers are small doesn't mean they don't have the same composting ability. Oh, they do. I've had them teeny. And like devour things. That doesn't matter. These just happen to be like that because I'm fattening them up with my worm chow. Oh, look at that. Let's see what they're doing down here. Yeah, they're, wow, look at them. They're all here. Nice looking worms. Oh. Every time I open this up, I see something. Let's not disturb them. Sorry, guys. And I had this bag when I was storing the newspaper, so they're going to eat that too. Let's see these guys in here. How about you, but I get excited when I see like a swarm like this. They're very active. Oh, look at them. Wow. They're doing great. So we're gonna give these guys some strawberries. I'm just gonna put it right down the middle. I need to give these guys more bedding. But I'm going to do that later. All right. There's a hole. Let's give them a few. What do we call this one? Strawberry row? Enjoy that, guys. They're definitely gonna like that. So see, it's getting a little dry on this side. I think it's from that vent. But you know, it's starting to get cold here. And today, when I woke up, the house was 69. So, and it's gonna be like that for the rest of the week. So I decided to turn the heat on. Usually I wait longer. But lately, it feels really cold in here. So, yeah, I turned the heat on. Sorry, guys. Let's give them some strawberries right here. So, you know what I'm waiting for that comes next? The leaves. The leaves are coming. And when it rains leaves out there, you'll know. I know I have it in some of my past videos if you want to go look. If not, you know, that's okay. I'm going to obviously have more leaves falling. But it's insane. And what happens is they all dry up, right? Up there in the trees. And then all of a sudden we start getting like a lot of wind and they all go flying. My dogs go crazy. They love it. They love the leaves. Plus, it just gives it a nice fall feeling, you know? Let's give these guys a little bit of this. So, no, I don't give my Girl Out bins usually food, like fresh food, even though sometimes I have just to spoil them a little bit. But the nursery bins are usually, they get everything. Only because if I have to harvest one of those, having the mushy food in there will just make it harder on me. I'll just have to wait till they finish it then, or try to move it out. And that would be like, that would be a hot mess. It really would. It really would. So, you guys want to know what I put in here? Okay. I make the spray to encourage the microbes in the worm bins, because when there's more microbes, there's more for them to eat. The worms actually eat the microbes, and it just makes the environment healthy, and they like it, and it gets them really active. So it's the simplest thing on the planet. Even though there's a company that had contacted me that they are mailing me a liquid that I'm gonna dilute, and I'm gonna try it on one of my bins. Just I might do it on theirs just to see if it works the way I want it to work. So this is just, let me go get it. Molasses. It has to be that one, unsulfurated. I make a big giant milk jug of it. So guys, if you're not going to use your spray right away, don't make that much. Just make a teeny little bottle and use it. It doesn't last long on the shelf and it'll start to smell weird, and you don't want to spray that in your worm bins. I make as much as I make because I use it on everything in here. But for you all like that are home, I would just do a teeny bit. It doesn't last more than, I would say, 3 or 4 days, and then you got to throw it out. So yeah, this will last a long time. If you just put it in your one little spray bottle, I would do like a quarter of a teaspoon in one of my little pink bottles. And that way I could use it up and then get rid of it. And it's not really a huge cost, you know, thing. So, yeah. Remember, it has no preservatives or anything in it. So, yeah, it'll smell weird. But man, do the worms love it. Oof. They do. See, I make this, and then I just refill my little bottle. For this size, which is a half gallon, I put about a tablespoon and a half, like no more than that. And then I fill it with warm water up to here. I shake it so it can start melting, and then I add just regular water. And I refill my little bottle. Now, that's just with the molasses. I have made it with this also. Besides the molasses, I have added kelp, but I'm not sure about doing it like that, because honestly I don't see a difference. I don't think it helps anything, so I'm just going to keep that for my garden. But this is one way to make the spray. Another way to make the spray is, if you want to take the time and just make it yourself, you take a bucket like that cat litter bucket, and you take this You take a motor that's meant for aquariums and the little tube, and you get a stone. Now this stone, when you put it in your bucket of water, it's gonna bubble. And you take a mesh bag. Let's see, Joe got me this bucket so I could make one. Let me sit down over here. So you take a mesh bag like this and you fill it up with your worm castings or compost from the yard. But since I'm indoors, you know, I use my own castings, and I hang it inside with the water and the bubbler. And I just start, let it bubble, 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 bubble. That sounded weird. Then I add about, for this size bucket, which is not very big, I would add about a teaspoon, teaspoon and a half of molasses, and stir it real good and just keep it bubbling. When that bubbles, the next day, you can strain the liquid. Make sure the liquid is strained and it doesn't have any little particles. Because if it does, it just takes, it doesn't last as long. It'll start rotting in an anaerobic way, which is, you don't want that. So if there are no particles in it, it will last longer. But remember, we're not adding any preservatives or any chemicals, so it's not going to last forever. And then you could take, that's called worm tea, and you can take that and strain it and put it in like one of these things or the little hand squirter thing. I don't add my worm tea to this because I'm so afraid that if a little particle goes in there, it might clog this. And I can't take that chance because this machine was not cheap. This holds 4 gallons of water and it is battery operated, but I have to charge it. And then I pick this up and I go bin by bin and I spray everything. So basically that's how I make my tea, my sprayer. You want to do it the fast way, do this. You want to do it on the other way, you can make your own worm tea. Another substitution, if you don't have molasses, you can use maple syrup, you can use brown sugar. I've done that because I didn't have any of these things and it worked fine. You just have to mix it with warm water and make sure these things melt, you know. And you can use like Cairo syrup. So you got to think about sugar, you know. Sugar is what gets the worms excited. It really does. And the sugar will create the microbes, and that's when everything else comes into play. I also wanted to tell you, if you decide you want this spray in a larger quantity, you don't want it to go bad, what I would suggest to do is get yourself like one of these buckets or any bucket, put your molasses in it, mix it well, and use the bubbler. I think that it'll last longer if it has bubble circulation in it, oxygen. If you let it just sit there, it will go bad. I know it will. So you could try that and just see what happens. So that is my secret recipe for my spray. So when I feed, I sprinkle it. I wet it with water. If it's already damp, I just use the spray. And even if I wet it with water, I spray a little bit on the surface. 2 or 3 pumps, doesn't take a lot. And then you end up with worms like I showed you. So, you know, a lot of people don't give away these type of secrets, but I do because, you know, honestly, you need the help and I'm willing to give it to you. What else do I do? Yeah, compost tea or worm tea. When I've made it outside in that bucket, I have put fish emulsion in it. But I won't do that in here because fish emulsion, it kind of smells a little bit. And, you know, me and smells, we don't do that great together. But this is indoors, an indoor wormery that's temperature controlled, and I'm not going to bring that fishy smell in here. So if you want to do it outside, that's what you do. I did find some leaves. So we're going to be feeding those. I'm going to show you how I do that. You have to make sure the leaves are really dry. Like this one is dry, but it's still on the green side. So I'm just going to let this sit a little bit. So what do you think, guys? Go make yourself some
worm tea, worm spray. What should we call it? Give me some ideas down below. I need a name for my worm spray. I don't just want to call it worm spray. It sounds too boring. What do you want to call it? Tell me down below. Like and subscribe my channel. If you're new here, I hope you enjoy my content. They call me the weird worm lady, but you know, that's okay. I've been the weird worm lady for like 20 years now, and I absolutely love it. And you know, I'm going to do this until I die. So I'm coming up with a master plan for the wall here. And, you know, it's taken me some time because I really, really want to think through it. All these labels, I have to remove them and start them again. So we're going to see. We're going to see. So are you guys doing well? I am. I think in my next video, we're going to do the pumpkins. We're going to feed them. This one's starting to get soft. And I'm also going to give you a tip and trick about the pumpkins, what I do. And the worms absolutely love it. All right, guys. So take care. And I see you next time. Take care.